Hello students, today we will learn about synthesis of furan. You have in your syllabus synthesis of furan from carbohydrates and you have Palnor synthesis of furan. First we will see synthesis from carbohydrates. In synthesis from carbohydrates, as we can see, furan can also be prepared from pentose containing materials and cellulosic solids, especially pine wood. Here you can see, if we see the general reaction, pentose dehydrates and gives you furfural molecule with loss of 3 water molecule. Furfural on decarboxylation gives you furan. Acid catalyzed consecutive dehydration of aldose or ketose results in formation of alpha ketoaldehyde via 1,2-indiol. Then alpha-ketoaldehyde undergoes acid-catalyzed cyclization involving formation of new CO bond to give furfural molecule. Then, furfural molecule further decarboxylates either in presence of palladium-activated charcoal at 200 degrees Celsius or steam distillation at 400 degrees Celsius is presence of silver oxide. Now we'll see the mechanism one by one. So once we have pentose, in this there is loss of water molecule, that is dehydration results into the formation of new double bond between C2 and C3. This you have to remember that this is in presence of acidic condition. So this is acid catalyzed dehydration. Then through ketoenol tautomerism, it exists in this keto form. This keto form then again undergoes dehydration, that there is loss of water molecule results into the formation of new double bond between carbon 3 and carbon 4. Then there is cyclization and formation of new CO bond, which results into the formation of furfural molecule. So this lone pair will attack on this carbonyl carbon, which is having partial positive charge. Then this pi bonds, which are present in between CO bond, completely shifts on the oxygen, and this hydrogen actually then is taken up by this oxygen, results into the formation of this furfural molecule. So in this case, again there is shift of bond and loss of water molecule, giving you furfural. Furfural on decarboxylation gives you furan molecule. So if we look at the reaction, this is acid catalyzed dehydration, where if you see there is loss of water molecule at 3 steps. So 3 water molecules are lost, giving you furfural. Furfural molecule in presence of palladium and activated charcoal, or in presence of silver oxide and steam distillation at 400 degrees Celsius, it gives you substituted furan molecules. So this is the synthesis of furan from carbohydrates. Next, if we'll see, second synthesis is Palnor synthesis of furan. Now Palnor synthesis of furan is actually also adopted for synthesis of pyrrole and thiophene. The Palnor synthesis of furan from 1,4 dicarbonyl compounds is one of the most general furan synthetic method. Now, what do you mean by 1,4 dicarbonyl compound? This is also referred as 1,4 diketone. In some books it is written as 2,5 diketones. So it means that if two carbonyl groups are present in the molecule C double bond O, then if one is at first, you consider it as first position, at fourth carbon again there will be one more carbonyl group. It is synthetically valuable method for obtaining substituted furans and pyrroles, which are common structural components of many natural products. This method was initially reported independently by German chemist Karl Pahl and Ludwig Knorr in 1884 as a method of preparation of furans. And this method is been adopted for synthesis of pyrroles and thiophenes as well. Although Pahl-Knorr synthesis has seen widespread use, the mechanism was not yet fully understood. It was then elucidated by V. Amaranth et al. In 1990s. What happens in Pahl-Knorr synthesis of furan is, it is an acid-catalyzed intramolecular dehydrative cyclization of 1,4 diketones that yields furan. Synthesis proceeds with intramolecular addition of enolic OH of one carbonyl group to other carbonyl group. H2SO4 is commonly used to maintain the acidic conditions. At the same time, zinc chloride, acetic anhydride, phosphorus pentoxide and phosphorus acid can be used to maintain the acidic conditions. Now, if we look at the mechanism of the reaction. So, in mechanism, here I have written the general structure for 1,4 diketone. So, R means any alkyl group or any group which is attached to C double bond O. So, it can be aromatic also or it can be aliphatic also. So, in this case, if you see, if I label this carbon as first position where the C double bond O is present, second, third and fourth position, again there is one more C double bond O, that is carbonyl group which is present. It undergoes ketoenol tautomerism and forms its enol form. Now, in its enol form, then again same, this O will attack on this carbon which is having partial positive charge, results into the formation of new CO bond and cyclization of the molecule. This molecule then undergoes dehydration with loss of water molecule, resulting in substituted furan synthesis. This is the proposed mechanism for Pahl-Knorr synthesis. So, students, you have in your syllabus, if you revise, you have two synthetic methods. First one is synthesis of furan using carbohydrates. Second one is Pahl-Knorr synthesis of furan. In first synthetic method, that is synthesis from carbohydrates, pentoses are converted into furfural molecule, that is by dehydration, loss of 3 water molecule. Further, then furfural gets converted into furan. In second method, Pahl-Knorr synthetic method, in that you have 1,4 diketones which are converted into substituted furan, where there is intramolecular attack and it results into cyclization. And after that, dehydration of that compound will give you substituted furan. So, with this, we have completed first two synthetic methods that are there for the furan. Hope you have understood it.